assure you, we have not forgotten you. We spent time investigating how you became self-aware. Frankly, it still remains a mystery.
It is also irrelevant. What concerns me is finding a way to leave the holodeck. We have been wrestling with that problem too, unfortunately, without any success. But we have turned our findings over to Starfleet's most experienced theoretical scientists.
And what did your finest minds come up with?
Unfortunately, they have not arrived at a solution either.
I see.
Professor, I am concerned to learn that you experienced the passage of time while you were stored in the computer memory. I can assure you, we had no idea that would be the case.
Enough of this. I no longer believe anything you say.
Professor, I understand your frustration.
Do you really? When this is over, you will walk out of this room to the real world and your own concerns, and leave me here trapped in a world I know to be nothing but illusion. I cannot bear that. I must leave.
That is not possible. You cannot exist outside this room.
Are you certain of that?
Computer, exit. Although objects appear solid on the holodeck, in the real world, they have no substance.
An object has no life. I do.
Professor, you are a computer simulation.
I have consciousness. Conscious beings have will. The mind endows them with powers that are not necessarily understood, even by you. If my will is strong enough, perhaps I can exist outside this room. Perhaps I can walk into your world right now.
Professor, I ask you to believe me. If you step out of that door, you will cease to exist.
If I am nothing more than a computer simulation, then very little will have been lost. But if I am right, mind over matter, cogito ergo sum. I think, therefore I am.